is a perimeter problem of a triangle. The perimeter of the triangle shown is 85 meters. Find the lengths of its sides. So we've got a picture here of a triangle. We've got three sides. And to get the perimeter of any shape, you simply add up the sides. So I'm going to add the three sides up. The first side, right? Plus the second side. That's the second side, right? Plus the third side is 85. Because it says the perimeter is 85. All right, so let's simplify the left-hand side. I've got x squared plus 4x plus 8 equals 85. All right, this is a quadratic because it has an x squared term. So we're going to have to set this equal to 0 and factor. So x squared plus 4x. All right, if I subtract 85 from both sides, do that, you should have minus 77. Subtracting 85 from both sides. Okay, again, next step would be to factor. So we have x and x. All right, so we need factors of 77. We have to have a difference of 4. Well, there's not that many factors of 77. 7 and 11 sort of screams out at me. And I want to have a plus in front of the 11 and a minus in front of the 7 to get the plus 4x. All right, so x minus 7 is 0, or x plus 11 is 0. So x could be 7, or x could be negative 11. All right, let's see if x could be 7. Well, if we put in a 7 here, that side would be 14, 2 times 7. So we know one possibility is this would be 14. All right, if we put in a 7 here, we'd have 2 times 7, which is 14 plus 5. That would be 19. And if we put a 7 here, we have 7 squared, which is 49 plus 3. That's 52. So the question is, could that be the length of the sides? Actually, no. Because if two sides only add up to 14 and 19 add up to 33, the last side is going to have to be smaller than 33. So x equals 7 is not a solution. Okay? All right. Now, let's look at x equals negative 11. So we tried that. Let's just draw the picture again. Convince yourself that if you add the two smaller sides together, it's got to be bigger than the third side. That's why this triangle can't exist. You can't have a triangle like that. Although it looks like, if you're not careful, you might think that's the answer. All right, let's put in negative 11 for x. Well, if I put in 2 times negative 11, that'd be negative 22. Okay, forget that right there. Okay, you know what? There's no solution to this one.